Three decades have passed since I stood on the king's dais. Three decades of love and laughter, song and sentiment, friendships old and new. Is that what it all meant, then? The grand lesson to take away from an exceedingly ordinary life? The reason for holding on through winter, through times of shadow? That there will always be light waiting on the other side, and that you can still help folks in the meantime. I know Graham worries, so I've kept quiet on my nightly strolls. It's easy knowing the steps like the back of my hand. These days it isn't the creaking of floorboards to listen for, but the creaking of my old bones. Once more then, out into my beloved pyre side. I shouldn't have gone out on my own. I know that now. These past few days, I've been confined to my bed to rest up. Or, has it been weeks? I suppose it doesn't matter. I find myself overcome with that curious longing unique to the end of things. The dregs of a warm cup of tea. The moment the setting sun gets swallowed up in a twilight sky. The final chapter of your favorite fantasy novel. Content, but wishing it could have lasted just a bit longer. My novel. My story. It's meant little to a lot of folks, but an awful lot to a few. They're here now, beside me. Eyes shut, I can see them still. Graham. My blue-eyed farm boy, keeper of my heart for half a century. Hazel, clever, creative Hazel, my protege and deepest source of pride. Claire, my unexpected friend, a fierce flame that has never gone out. Noah. Hope for the future. I never had children, but through Noah, I know the village I cherish will live on. I see their faces, full of love. I see all the moments across the years that have brought them here, to be with me now. And I swear I can see something else. Warm and wondrous, shimmering just beyond the window glass. Tiny, twinkling pyre lights.
Ooh.